Dear students, welcome back to a new mathematics session. In today's session, we shall discuss question number 20 to 23 from exercise 6.5. Let's move on to the topic. Let's begin with question number 20. Show that the right circular cylinder of given surface and maximum volume is such that its height is equal to the diameter of the base. So here, there is a right circular cylinder. So this is the right circular cylinder and a given surface means surface area is given, it is a constant. Surface area means the total surface area is given, it is a constant, and the maximum volume, this is a condition, maximum volume is such that its height is equal to the diameter of the base. Means maximum volume, we have to maximize the volume. While maximizing the volume, when the volume will be maximum, the volume will be maximum when the height is equal to the diameter of the base. Means height is h is equal to the diameter of the base. Diameter of the base means here base radius is r, so diameter of the base means 2r. So h is equal to 2r, we have to prove. That is what the question, we need to prove that h is equal to 2r. We have to maximize the volume. Maximize the volume means we have to differentiate volume with respect to something. That variable you have to find out. Okay. And given surface. Given surface means the total surface. It is mentioned only surface here. Only surface is mentioned means the total surface area we have to take. Total surface area is a constant here. But R and H will be changing. R and H are the variables. But surface area, when you consider, that will be fixed constant there, and based on R and H the variations will be there. R and H we have to change, but S remains the constant. S means the surface area. Okay, so here let's try to solve this one. R, H be the radius and height of a cylinder respectively. We have assumed that one, right? R is the radius and H is the height. V and S be the volume and the surface area of the cylinder. So here V and S, capital letter V and S represents the volume and the surface area. Surface area of the cylinder, we know since it is mentioned the surface area, we consider the total surface area. Total surface area formula is 2 pi r square. Means the total two circular faces are there. One is at the top and another one is at the bottom. So pi r square plus pi r square, 2 pi r square. And the curved surface area is 2 pi r h. So like that, 2 pi r square plus 2 pi r h is the surface area of cylinder. That means here S is equal to 2 pi r square plus 2 pi r h. As I said before, surface here, fixed surface, given surface is there. That means this S will be fixed here. R and H are the variables. Then when the volume will be maximum, it is height will be equal to the diameter of the base. That means 2r. H is equal to 2r, we have to prove. Now, from here, this 2 pi r square we can take to the left side. Actually, either you have to find out r or h, you have to find out, okay, because we need that variables in one variable in terms of another one while doing the differentiation. But r and h are the variables here. But if you check r here, there is one r here, one r square, means something common factor you have to take out, it will be complicated. Instead, if you go for finding h, that will be easy. So I'm just going to calculate h from here. So 2 pi r h I'm keeping one side, s minus 2 pi r square we have taken on the left side. Then s minus 2 pi r square divided by here 2 pi r, just bringing to the left side, means comes to the denominator, that is equal to h. Then h is equal to s minus 2 pi r square by 2 pi r. Just keep it as equation number 1. Then volume of the cylinder, we know that the formula pi r square h. Now v is equal to pi r square as pi r square h as per our assumption. Then we need to maximize the volume that we have already discussed before. We need to maximize the volume. That means v is equal to pi r square. Now it is a double variable is there. R and h both are variables. So what you have to do is you have to change it to a single variable. For that only this calculation we have done. Take h and substitute here. So pi r square into h is s minus 2 pi r square by 2 pi r, we have substituted. Then v is equal to pi r square by 2 pi r. Here denominator 2 pi r is there, just keep it together with the numerator, pi r square by 2 pi r into s minus 2 pi r square. Then here there is a pi common, cancel. There is an r common, that also we can cancel. If you want, we'll show that here pi and pi we can cancel, and here r square and 1 r we can cancel. Then we'll be getting as r by 2 into s minus 2 pi r square. Then from here, this r we can take inside, because r is also a variable. So we can, if you keep it outside, again then product rule and all we have to use. Instead we can keep it inside, so that the differentiation will be easy for us. Only constant we can keep outside, 1 by 2 constant into r, if you take inside, s into r sr minus 2 pi r. Here there is a square, here there is r, so r square into r is 2 pi r cube. Then differentiate with respect to r. Here now there is only one variable, that is r, and v is there on the left side. So differentiate with respect to r means dv by dr will be coming. Dv by dr is equal to 1 by 2 is a constant, we can keep outside, then d by dr of sr minus 2 pi r cube. Then 1 by 2 into the derivative of sr, s is a constant, derivative of r is 1, because we are differentiating with respect to r, derivative of r is 1, minus here 2 pi is a constant, r cube derivative is 3 r square, that 3 and these 2 multiplying times 6, so 6 pi r square, that is dv by dr. Then putting dv by dr is equal to 0, we'll be getting 1 by 2 into s minus 6 pi r square is equal to 0. That means s minus 6 pi r square is equal to 0. Means 1 by 2 constant, it is not possible to equate with 0. So s minus 6 pi r square is equal to 0. Then here s value is there with us. We have calculated s value, 2 pi r square, surface area, 2 pi r square plus 2 pi r h. This is substitute, 2 pi r square plus 2 pi r h minus 6 pi r square is equal to 0. Now here when you check 2 pi r square minus 6 pi r square, that is minus 4 pi r square plus 2 pi r h is equal to 0. And when you check here, what is common here, 2 we can take common, then pi we can take common, r also we can take common. That means 2 pi r we can take common. Of course there is an h extra is there, so this h is not needed. Okay, so this h is not necessary. So 2 pi r into, then 2 pi r going from the first term means there is 1 2 balance, there is a minus balance, 2 also balance, then 1 r is outside, 1 r is left behind the minus 2 r, plus here 2 pi r h. Out of that, first 3 is outside, 2 pi r, then balance plus h is equal to 0. Then here 2 pi r into h minus r is equal to 0. Again there is an additional h, please avoid this one. That's why 2 pi r into h minus r, h minus 2 r is equal to 0. Just we are rearranging it, that's all. Then here h minus 2 r, when we equate with 0, we will be getting h is equal to 2 r. So we have got h is equal to double of the radius. So when we equate dv by dr with 0, we have got h is equal to 2r. Means that is what actually we have to prove, height is equal to the diameter of the base. But we need to prove that this is the maximum value, that is what we have to prove. For that, we have to find out d square v by dr square. So dv by dr, we know that 1 by 2 into s minus 6 pi r square, that we have calculated in the previous slide. Differentiate with respect to r. Once again, means it will be d square v by dr square is equal to, here 1 by 2 is a constant and s is also a constant, means derivative of a constant is 0, minus here 6 pi into derivative of r square. R square is 2r. That 2 into 6 when you multiply, 12 pi r will be coming. So how we, once again we'll explain, r square, derivative of r square is 2r. So that 2r multiply with 6 pi, that means 12 pi r will be coming. That is equal to, clearly 0 minus 12 pi r is minus 12 pi r. That minus 12 pi r and dividing with the 2 means we will be getting minus 6 pi r. It is a negative term. That means less than 0 for h is equal to 2 r. Since d square v by dr square is less than 0, volume of a cylinder is maximum when h is equal to 2 r. This is the proof. Next we shall discuss question number 21. Of all the closed cylindrical cans of a given volume of 100 cubic centimeters, find the dimensions of the can which has the minimum surface area. Here, of all the closed cylindrical can means, of course, it is a right circular cylinder of a given volume. Here volume is given, volume is a constant, 100 cubic centimeter, and we have to minimize the surface area here. So just opposite of the previous question, what it is, surface area was given, there we have to maximize the volume. Here volume is fixed, volume is given to us constant, and we have to minimize the surface area, just opposite of the previous question. So what we have to do is, here there is a right circular cylinder we can take, the dimensions r and h we can take, and let r and h be the radius and height of the cylinder respectively, v and s be the volume and surface area of cylinder respectively. And here r and h are the variables, r and h will change, but the volume is fixed, volume is 100 cubic centimeter, and there are some combinations of r and h, we can change r and h accordingly, but the volume should remain constant, 100. So in we have to minimize the surface area. After minimization means, when we minimize the surface area, we should get or we have to find out the radius and height. What will be the radius and what will be the height when we minimize the surface area? That is what the question. So here we have to write the volume of the cylinder formula first, because volume is given to us, pi r square h. So volume v is equal to pi r square h. V we can it is given to us, it is 100. So 100 is equal to pi r square h. Here, as I mentioned before, r square, if you take, square root will be coming, so that we can leave r square alone, and we can take h, because both are variables. By finding out the derivative, we need all in one single variable we have to convert. But if you take r square here, square root will be coming. Finding the derivative will be a little complicated. So instead, if you take h, it will be easy. So that's why we are taking h here, which is equal to 100 by pi r square. Then we need to minimize the surface area. Surface area, we know, it is last slide also we have discussed. Formula is 2 pi r h plus 2 pi r square. S is equal to 2 pi r h plus 2 pi r square. S is the letter we have given for surface area. Then we can just substitute the values of h here. S is equal to 2 pi r into h is 100 by pi r square plus 2 pi r square. Now everything is in single variable, that is r. That is, s is equal to, just we can take a pi r inside, okay? Because there are pi r square in the denominator, some cancellation we can do. So 2 into pi r and pi r square, when we just do the cancellation, it will be going pi and pi will be cancelled, and there is 1 r in the numerator, 1 r in the denominator, that can be cancelled. So 2 into 100 by r plus, here nothing can be cancelled, 2 pi r square. Then s is equal to 2 into 100, that is 200 by r plus 2 pi r square. So maximum calculation we have done in s here. Now we have to take this r to the numerator, so that it will be easy for us to do the derivation, or else 1 by r minus 1 by r square, that way also you can do it, it's not an issue. But here I am taking r to the numerator. S is equal to 200 into r power minus 1 plus 2 pi r square. We have to minimize the value of s. For that, s is equal to 200 r power n r power minus 1 plus 2 pi r square. We have to differentiate with respect to r. There are some step additional is written here. If it is not, now if you feel that it is not necessary, no need to write, okay? Directly we can go from here to this step, okay? Differentiate with respect to r, it's not an issue. So ds by dr is equal to 200 into r power minus 1, so minus 1 into r power minus 1 minus 1. That is a formula, okay? Derivative of x power n is n into x power n minus 1. So n is here minus 1, minus 1 into r power n minus 1. N is minus 1, again minus 1. So minus 1 r power minus 1 minus 1. Lot of minus 1 is visible here. Please don't get panic. Then 2 pi r square. Derivative of r square is 2 r. So 2 r power 2 minus 1 is written. Here we have used the formula directly. Here also it is mentioned. That's what, if you are able to do it directly, just to do it here. Since I have shown the calculation, here also it is mentioned. That's all. So r square derivative is 2r. That's all. Here it is 2r. Then here minus into 200, that is minus 200. R power minus 1 into minus, so minus 1 minus 1 is minus 2. Plus here 2 into 2, 4 pi r. Okay. And as I mentioned before, from here directly you can come to this step, it is not an issue, because 200 is a constant. Derivative of 1 by r is minus 1 by r square, that we can write here. Plus here 2 pi into derivative of r square is 2r, so 2 into 2, 4 pi r, directly we can write, it's not an issue. So that is up to you to proceed. So we have calculated ds by dr. Then we have to equate ds by dr with 0. That means ds by dr is minus 200 r power minus 2 plus 4 pi r equal to 0. From here we are going to calculate the value of r. So this r power minus 2 we can bring to the denominator. Minus 200 by r square plus 4 pi r is equal to 0. Take this r square common denominator, then minus 200 plus 4 pi r into r square is 4 pi r cube equal to 0. In this one we can multiply it and it will be eliminated. Minus 200 plus 4 pi r cube equal to 0. Then take this minus 200 to the right side, 4 pi r cube is equal to 200. Pi r cube is equal to 4, we can bring to the denominator, 200 by 4. That means pi r cube is equal to 50. From here r cube is 50 by pi. Then r cube, from r cube if you want to calculate r, it will be coming cube root of 50 by pi. Instead of cube root, we will be writing as power 1 by 3. Because cube root and power 1 by 3 both represents the same. So r is equal to 50 by pi, the whole power 1 by 3. This is the value of r. Now what we have to do is we have to verify that this is the minimum. When we put this one, the surface area S is getting the minimum value. For that we need to go for calculating the value of d square s by dr square. Means you have to differentiate this one once again with respect to r. So ds by dr we have minus 200 r power minus 2 plus 4 pi r. Then again if you are differentiating, d square s by dr square is equal to minus 200 is a constant. This is x power n format. X power n means n into x power n minus 1. That means minus 2 into r power minus 2 minus 1. Okay, that is written. Plus 4 pi into derivative of r is 1. So 4 pi into 1 is 4 pi. Then minus into minus plus, 200 into 2 is 400. R power minus 2 minus 1 is minus 3 plus 4 pi. Then putting the value of r, let's check this value, substitute and check. That means the little adjustment also we can do here. 400 r power minus 3, we can write it as 400 by r cube. Okay, then we are substituting. So 400 divided by r cube. R cube is 50 by pi, the whole power 1 by 3. Then cube power 3 plus 4 pi. So here there is a 1 by 3 and there is a 3. This we can cancel. That means we are getting 400 by 50 by pi plus 4 pi. Here also little work is there, calculation work. Let's try it. That is 400 is one quantity. This is, that is in the numerator. 400 we can write. Then into that 50 by pi, we can write it as pi by 50. Okay, pi by 50 we can write. Plus right side is there is another part is only 4 pi. Is there nothing to do? Just keep as it is. And here 50 and 400, it will be coming as 8 times. So we have got as 8 pi plus 4 pi. 8 pi plus 4 pi is 12 pi. It is a positive quantity. Means greater than 0. So d square s by ds dr square at r is equal to 50 pi by whole, sorry, 50 by pi the whole power 1 by 3, we get positive value. That means d square s by dr square is greater than 0 at r is equal to 50 by pi the whole power 1 by 3. Hence s is minimum at r is equal to 50 by pi the whole power 1 by 3. R value we have got, then corresponding h value also we have to find out. Putting value of r in 50 by pi the whole power 1 by 3 centimeter, where in h, so h is equal to 100 divided by pi into 50 by pi the whole power 1 by 3 the whole square. Means here we previously we have calculated and kept there h is equal to 100 by pi r square. That is the previous slide we calculated and we kept the h value. So there we are replacing r and putting, that's all. So 100 divided by pi into r value is 50 by pi the whole power 1 by 3 the whole square, pi r square. Then it will work, 100 divided by pi into 50 by pi. Then this 1 by 3 and 2 when we multiply will be coming as 2 by 3. So pi into 50 by pi the whole power 2 by 3. This pi and this pi please don't cancel because here there is power. Then 100 by pi, this 100 by pi we can keep outside. Then here 50 by pi is there, we can take the reciprocal. That means pi by 50 the whole power 2 by 3. Okay. Then what we have done is denominator, we have take the numerator and take the, we have taken the reciprocal and multiplying, that's all. So 100 by pi into 50 by pi reciprocal is pi by 50. Then we multiplied with the numerator, that's all. Now that is equal to 100 by pi into, just remove this bracket, pi power 2 by 3 divided by 50 power 2 by 3. Now here little bit of work is there. This 100 we are just splitting. Okay, 100 we are splitting as, just a minute, we will write, I will show you here. This 100 we are splitting as 2 into 50, okay? 2 into 50, why we are splitting that I will show you. 2 into 50. Then what we are doing is this 2 we are keeping as it is, 2 is written, okay? Then here, this 50 and this 50 power 2 by 3 that we are grouping together means this 50 power 2 by 3 when we bring to the numerator it comes as minus, power will come as minus. So here there is a power 1, so 50 power 1 minus 2 by 3 that will be coming this one, okay? This is the way it is written. Then this pi power 2 by 3 we are bringing to the denominator, that means pi power, here denominator is 1 is there, so 1 minus 2 by 3, that is what the explanation, okay? Once again, this 100 what we have done is we have split it as 2 into 50. Why we have done 2 into 50? Because the denominator there is a 50 power 2 by 3. We can do the calculation there, that's why. So this 50 power 1 and this 50 power 2 by 3 when we bring to the numerator, powers we have to subtract, 1 minus 2 by 3, that is what it is written. There is a 2 separated and kept here. Then here pi power 2 by 3 and pi power 1, when we bring this one to the denominator. Why we are bringing this one denominator means denominator is having higher quantity, that's why. So pi power 1 minus 2 by 3. Then when we do the calculation, 2 we can keep it, 50 into 1 minus 2 by 3, that is 3 into 1, 3, 3 minus 2 is 1. So 50 power 1 by 3, here also same thing only, 3 into 1, 3, 3 minus 2 is 1 by 3, pi power 1 by 3. So 50 power 1 by 3, pi power 1 by 3, that means there is power 1 by 3 is common, we can take out. So 2 into 50 by pi, the whole power 1 by 3, that is the value of h. So hence the total surface area is least when the radius of the base is 50 by pi the whole power 1 by 3 and the height is 2 into 50 by pi the whole power 1 by 3 centimeter. Next we shall discuss the 22nd question. A wire of length 28 meter is to be cut into two pieces. One of the pieces is to be made into a square and the other into a circle. What would be the length of the two pieces so that the combined area of the square and the circle is minimum? Here a wire is given to us, the length of wire is 28 meter and we are going to cut it into two pieces, and in that two pieces one of the pieces is to be made into a square. One piece we are making a square and the other we are making into a circle. What would be the length of the two pieces? In how much length we need to cut the two pieces in such a way that the combined area of the square and the circle is minimum. So the square and the circle, what we are forming with these cut wires, they should have the combined minimum area. In which length we have to cut this wire? That is what the question. Okay. That means there is a wire is given. Let's visualize this one so that a little bit easy for you to understand. So it is cutting from here. So that particular length we can consider as x. If this piece is x, means this piece will be total length 28 minus this one. That means 28 minus x. Then this x piece we are making it into form in the form of a square. Okay, and this 28 minus x we are making it in the form of a circle. Okay, and let's write it. A wire of length 28 meter, cut it into two parts. Then let x be the length of the first part that we have taken, then length of the second part be 28 minus x, that is also we have explained. Then given that one part is converted into a square, that means this x piece, the length of x piece, sorry, a piece whose length is x meter, we have converted into square. That the length of x meter be converted into a square means the perimeter of square is x, means this total length only we have used for making the entire square, means the perimeter will be equal to x. Perimeter of square, we know that 4 into side is equal to x, that means side of the square will be x by 4. That is what it is mentioned here. Directly if you are able to write, write it, or else you write the step and write, it is up to you. Then other part is converted into a circle, that means this one 28 minus x portion, that is converted into a circle, means this 28 minus length, this 28 minus x length piece is converted into a circle, means 28 minus x is the circumference of this circle. That is what the statement, 28 minus x meter length converted into a circle of radius r, that means circumference of the circle is 28 minus x. So from here, radius we can calculate. Circumference of the circle formula is 2 pi r. 2 pi r is equal to 28 minus 6. So r is equal to this 2 pi we can bring to the right side. That is 28 minus 6 by 2 pi meter. Then for both the shapes, here there is a circle, we have got the radius. Here there is a square, we have got the side. Then we need to find the length of pieces. Means each length we have to find out so that the combined area of circle and square is minimum. Means when we add the area of this square and this circle, we should get the minimum area. So let's consider T be the total area. So let T be the total area of circle and square. Then T is equal to area of circle plus area of square. So area of circle means we need a formula, that is pi r square, plus area of square formula is side square. So r and radius and the side of the square we have calculated before, that is r is equal to 28 minus x by 2 pi, side we have got as x by 4. Let's substitute here. T is equal to pi into r, r is 28 minus x by 2 pi the whole square, plus side is x by 4. So x by 4 the whole square, that means x square by 4 square is x square by 16. This pi we can cancel, and here there is pi square will be there, that 1 pi also we can cancel. Okay, here there is pi square will be there, and here 1 pi we are just cancelling. Just keep it in mind. Okay, then we have to minimize t, that is what our a. Minimize means we have to differentiate with respect to x, because here the variable is x. So dt by dx is equal to, here numerator pi is not there, denominator there is 1 pi is there, because pi square was there, that pi is cancelled. Okay, remember that. Then 28 minus x the whole square means 2 into 28 minus x, that is the derivative, 2 into 28 minus x divided by, there is 1 4 is there, then pi square pi is cancelled, 1 pi is balanced, so 4 pi. Then into derivative of this 28 minus x will be coming again, plus here 16 is a constant, then derivative of x square is 2x, so 2x by 16. Then here 2 and 4 we can cancel, 2 and 4 cancelling means denominator 2 will be coming, so 28 minus x divided by 2 pi into derivative of 28 minus x is minus 1. Okay, d by dx of 28 is 0, then d by dx of x is minus 1, so minus 1 is written. Plus here 2 and 16 we can cancel 8 times, then x by 8 will be there. Then putting dt by dx is equal to 0, when we equate with 0, x minus 28 means this minus, when we multiply inside it will be changing, that is minus becomes plus x, plus 28 becomes minus 28 by 2 pi, plus x by 8 is equal to 0. Then 8 pi when you take as LCM, then here 2 and the common denominator is having 8, so 2 by 8 by 2 is 4, that 4 you have to multiply here, 4 and x minus 8 plus, then here 8 is there, pi we need to multiply, so x into pi equal to 0. That means numerator 4x minus 4 into 28, 4 into 28 is 112, plus pi x is equal to cross multiply 8 pi into 0. That is, in these two, when you take 4x and pi x, when you take, there is x common, we can take out, because we need to find out the value of x, that's why x when we take out, 4 balance plus pi balance, and this minus 112 we can bring to the denominator, sorry, right side, here this becomes 0, 0 plus 112 is 112. That means x is equal to 112 divided by 4 plus 5, sorry, 4 plus pi. Now let's find out d square t by dx square, because we need to check this, we need to minimize this, and whether this value is minimum or not, that is what we have to check. For that, d square t by dx square we have to calculate. Dt by dx we have calculated here, this is the one, okay, that is minus 28 plus x divided by 2 pi, just we multiply inside, okay, minus 28 plus x divided by 2 pi plus x by 8. Then d square t by dx square is, then here 1 by 2 pi if you take as constant outside, derivative of minus 28 is 0, derivative of x is 1, so 0 plus 1 plus 1 by 8 is a constant, derivative of x is 1, so 1 by 8 will become, that means d square t by dx square is equal to here 1 by 2 pi, because 0 plus 1 is 1, 1 into 1 by 2 pi is 1 by 2 pi, plus 1 by 8, this is clearly greater than 0. That means d square t by dx square is greater than 0 at x is equal to this value, 112 divided by 4 plus 5, 4 plus pi. The total area is minimum at x is equal to 112 by 4 plus pi. That is the conclusion. Then we have got one variable, that is x. Finding the length of the other part we have to, okay, x means we made it only the square, okay, the dimension of the square only we are getting. Then there is another part is there, that we 28 minus x, that we used to for making circle. Length of the other part is 28 minus x, that is 28 minus x is 112 by 4 plus 5. Then here 4 plus 5 common LCM, if you take, multiply this one with this one, this numerator, 28 into 4 plus 5 minus 112. Then that is when you do the calculation, 28 into 4, 28 to 112, that 112 and this minus 112 can be cancelled. Then 28 into pi, 28 pi is there, divided by 4 plus 5. The length of the first part is 112 divided by 4 plus pi. Then length of the another part or the second part is 28 pi divided by 4 plus pi. Next, we shall discuss question number 23. Prove that the volume of the largest cone that can be inscribed in a sphere of radius r is 8 by 27 of the volume of the sphere. Here, let's draw a diagram, and through the diagram, we will explain. Visualization is better. So there is a circle, outside circle. This circle represents the sphere. Okay. Then there is a cone inside the circle, means there is a, as per the question, there is a cone which is inscribed in the sphere. So cone we can inscribe, this is one way of inscribing. Another way, if you want to make it a little wider, you can go that way also. And if you want to make it a little taller, you can make it this way also. It's not an issue, okay? But here there is a condition. Among all those cones which is inscribing inside this sphere, the largest cone is the volume of the largest cone that is having a connection with the sphere volume, that is the volume of the largest cone will be equal to 8 by 27 of the volume of the sphere. The volume of the largest cone that can be inscribed in this sphere will be equal to 8 by 27 of the volume of the sphere. So here also something what we have to do is we have to volume of the largest cone means we have to maximize the volume, that is what we have to do. Okay, before that we have to do a lot of work here. Let's assume the radius of the sphere is r, and let's take this OC as x. Why we are taking OC as x means this is a right circular cone, means this angle will be 90 degree. So this angle, this triangle BOC we can consider as a right angle triangle, and from there BC we can calculate easily by using Pythagoras theorem. And the height of this cone, that is AC, that can be calculated by adding R plus X. BC will be getting by using Pythagoras theorem. So these are the some prerequisites that we are going to do before starting the actual calculation. So here, cone of the largest volume inscribed in the sphere of radius r. So radius of the sphere we have taken as r, and OC we have discussed before, OC we have assumed as x, and the radius of the cone, that is BC, that also we have discussed before. Height of the cone, that is this one, AC. AC means AO plus OC, okay, that we can keep. Then triangle BOC is a right angle triangle. BOC is a right angle triangle because this is a right circular cone, that's why. Then by using Pythagoras theorem, hypotenuse is OB. So OB square is equal to BC square plus OC square. So R square, OB means the radius, okay. R square is equal to BC square, we don't know. OC we have taken as X. From here BC square is equal to, take this R x square to the left side, R square minus x square will be coming. BC is equal to root of R square minus x square. The radius of the cone, we have got BC, that is equal to root of R square minus x square. Then height of the cone that we have calculated before, that is OC plus OA. OC plus OA means R plus X, we can write R plus X. Yeah, here itself we can write and give, it's not an issue. That we need to show that maximum volume of cone is equal to 8 by 27 of the volume of the sphere. This also we have discussed before. Volume of maximum volume of the cone means among all the cones which can be inscribed in this sphere, the volume of the largest cone will be equal to 8 by 27 of the volume of the sphere. This is what you have to prove. Then 8 by 27 of volume of the sphere formula we know, 4 by 3 into pi r cube. That is 48 into 432 divided by 27 into 3 is 81 pi r cube, capital R cube. Let V be the volume of a cone that we can take. We know that volume of the cone formula is 1 by 3 pi r square h. Here radius square into height. So V is equal to 1 by 3 pi into radius. We have calculated here root of r square minus x square the whole square, radius square, into h. H is r plus x. So V we have written and kept here. Then that is equal to 1 by 3 pi into this root and the square, both can be cancelled, r square minus x square into r plus x. Then 1 by 3 pi into here r square into r plus x, removing the bracket, okay, r square into r plus x minus x square into r plus x. Then that is equal to 1 by 3 pi into r square into r is r cube, then r square into x is r square x, minus x square into r is minus x square r, minus x square into x is minus x cube. So the rest of the calculation we will do it in the next slide. So once again we will just go through it here. What we have done first is we have assumed the radius r and this portion as x, and we have calculated the radius bc by using Pythagoras theorem. Then ac we have calculated. Then volume of the cone we have substituted that relation, that means 8 by 27 into volume of the sphere, that relation we need to prove there. The things we have substituted, volume of the sphere value, that means 4 by 3 pi r cube. Then we have calculated volume of the cone. Here also substitution is done. Radius value and height value we have substituted, and we are just proceeding the calculations. The rest of the calculation will do it in the next slide. We have calculated V is equal to 1 by 3 pi into r cube plus r square x minus x square r minus x cube. So this all well expanded format. So we can go for our work, differentiate with respect to x. So dv by dx is equal to, then here pi by 3 into, this is a constant, derivative 0 plus r square into derivative of x is 1 minus r into derivative of x square is 2x minus x cube derivative is 3x square. That is equal to pi by 3 into r square into 1 is r minus 2rx minus 3x square. That is equating with 0, dv by dx is equal to 0. That means 1 by 3 pi into r square minus 2rx minus 3x square is equal to 0. That means this quantity, this is a constant, so this quantity we can equate with 0. R square minus 2rx minus 3x square equal to 0. That means we have to split it, this one, by using the splitting middle term method, and we have to factorize it. Here the product is 1 into minus 3. Product is minus 3, sum is minus 2. The numbers are minus 3 and 1. Simple calculation. Once again, product is here 1, here minus 3. 1 into minus 3 is minus 3. Sum is minus 2. The numbers are minus 3 and 1. Minus 3 plus 1 is minus 2. So we split this one by using minus 3 and 1. Written as minus 3rx plus rx. The rest of the terms are same, first term and the last term. In these two terms, there is a common factor r, take out. Balance is r minus 3x. Plus in these two terms, there is x common, r minus 3x. Then here r minus 3x is common in both the terms, take out. In the first term, r balance. In the second term, x balance. That means x is equal to minus r. When you equate first bracket with the 0, we'll be getting x is equal to minus r. And the second one is x is equal to r by 3. Means r minus 3x is equal to 0 means x is equal to r by 3 will be coming. And here x is not, cannot be negative because x is a length. So this cannot be negative. So the only possibility is x is equal to r by 3. Then finding d square v by dx square. That is the next step. Because we are just going to find out the maximum, okay, volume, whether this is the maximum value or not, that's what we are going to check. For that, d square v by dx square we have to calculate. Here dv by dx we have got, that is 1 by 3 pi, here this is a value 1 by 3 pi r square minus 2rx minus 3x square. Then d square v by dx square, if you do, 1 by 3 pi again is a constant that we can keep. Then d by dx of this quantity, that is pi by 3 into d by dx of r square, it is a constant, 0. D by dx of x is 1, so minus 2r into 1 is minus 2r. Then d by dx of x square is 2x, 2x into 3 is 6x. That is equal to, here there is a minus common we can take out, that when we keep it with this one, minus pi by 3 into 2r plus 6x. Clearly it is a negative term. So putting x is equal to r by 3, minus pi by 3 into here 2r plus 6 into r by 3, okay. What we have done is x value we have substituted, that's all. X value we have calculated and kept here, that we have to substitute and check. That is minus pi by 3 into 2r plus 2r. Here 3 and 6 cancel and 2 will become. 2r plus 2r is 4r. That means minus pi by 3 into 4r, that is minus 4 pi r by 3, that is less than 0. Clearly less than 0. Here itself we know that it is clearly less than 0. So since it is less than 0, d square v by dx square is less than 0 when x is equal to 2 by 3. Volume is maximum when x is equal to r by 3. Volume will be maximum when x is equal to r by 3. So we have proved that the volume is maximum when x is equal to r by 3. Now we are going to find out the maximum volume. So finding the maximum volume, volume of cone, we have substituted the formula and kept it in the first slide. 1 by 3 pi r square h. Here r square means r square minus x square we have calculated into r plus x. This is a substituted form. Then just replace x and put the value r by 3. That means putting x is equal to r by 3. 1 by 3 pi into here r square minus x. X value is r by 3. So r by 3 the whole square into r plus x. X is r by 3. Little work is there. 1 by 3 pi into r square minus here r by 3 the whole square we can write as r square by 9. Then 3 into r 3 r plus r by 3. That is 1 by 3 pi into here 9 into r square, 9 r square minus r square, denominator 9. 3 r plus r is 4 r by 3. Then here 9 r square minus r square is 8 r square by 9. Here little work is there that will show you. Here what we are getting is 8 r square we are getting, 8 r square will write. Then we can see the calculation here. Then here this 8, this 8 and this 4, when we multiply, we'll be getting as 32. And here 3, 9, 9 into 9 is 81, that is in the denominator. Then here there is a pi, and here there is an r square, here there is an r, that is r cube. So together we have done the calculation, that's all. Dear students, today we have discussed questions 20 to 23 from the exercise 6.5. Comparatively, these questions are lengthy questions, and make sure that you practiced well before attending the online session. So while practicing, if you have any difficulty, please mark it and keep. We will discuss it during the discussion session. Thank you for watching.